glad to be part of God's body. Lord, you're welcome in mi casa. Heaven's only one big old body. Thankful for all we've been given. You always take care of your children. Every single moment we lift them up. All of God's people stay winning. Oh, we knew life would be all right. But who could have known it'd be this good? Oh, Lord, it gets better. Father, you give me grace that I don't deserve.
All right, 24 hours.
Oh.
Happy Sunday to everybody. We hope you had a Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. Join me in prayer just a quick second. God, thank you so much for this morning. We thank you for this choir. We thank you for the opportunity to sing of your mercy and your grace and your joy and your salvation this morning. We pray that our ears are opened and our eyes are open so that we could truly see your glory today. We pray that our faith is built upon hearing your word today. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Yeah, we pray you had a Merry Christmas, just remembering the birth of Christ. Giving those gifts was to remember the gifts that the wise men gave, those gifts that they would give a king. They gave a baby Jesus, the God who was infinite, who was became an infant to join us, to redeem us, and he lived that perfect life for us. I wanted to start by reading a passage from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 6. It says, "A voice says, cry. And I said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all its beauty is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of God will stand forever." So living for the flowers or pursuing the shiny things of this world will have you wandering without pasture. When they perish, when your life is invested in these things, when you're chasing the flowers or the pleasures of this world, when they cease, what is your faith built upon? What are you established on? When the pleasures of this world no longer has its taste, when that same pleasure or sin you once indulged in no longer has the same taste, what is your foundation built upon? That's the song we are singing, "Come to Christ, come to Christ." He died for all of our sin. Come to Christ. He is the light of the world. These doves represent His Holy Spirit. They represent His Holy Spirit as impurity, as the Son of God, as one who can make you new, who can make you clean, who can cleanse you from all unrighteousness. We live in times where we have many influences where within our technologies that pull our focus here. They tell us to follow this direction or build here or invest here. Some of those things are for sincere benefit in helping our livelihood, and some are for selfish gain, some that are just deceiving. Regardless of the cause of these influences, when these things fade away, God, who is infinite, remains. And what He's declared and established in His word remains. I want to read John chapter 1. "And the word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glory as the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." In highlight, this word was made manifest through the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. That Christmas day when God sent His Son to be born as someone who isn't infinite, He lived a full, perfect life that we couldn't live, a life that was without sin. He knew no sin, and He took on sin so that we can be made righteous before God without sin. Jesus accomplished what none of us could do, and of course, that was obeying God perfectly. Dying on a cross, resurrecting and defeating the curse of death, trusting in and believing in Jesus, that He was crucified for you, bearing your sin, and that God raised Him from the dead, you will be made new and holy. You will be saved. You will have eternal rest. If you happen to be walking in sin now, repent of it and turn to the light by entrusting your soul to Jesus. It's my son. If you happen to be walking in sin and are battling in it right now, or you may not know what you're doing right now, if it's sin, ask Jesus to show you what it is. He'll grant you the discernment. He's faithful to forgive you no matter how distant you may feel from him or how deep in something you may be in right now. It doesn't matter. God can free you from it. His mercies that we sing of, his grace when we were lost. He is the great shepherd. He is the great shepherd, and the sheep hear his voice. So when you're wandering, he can lead you beside still waters. To our fellow brothers and sisters, I encourage you to be that salt and light into this world as the world continues to change and doesn't remain on the word. It leads this way, tells us to build here. Stand firm in Christ. Share the gospel. Be salt, be that different taste so that when people see that difference in your life, they wonder, how are you so joyful in a time like this? It's because of Christ, what Christ has done for me, what he's done for us, what he's done for all of humanity. We can come to God, with childlike faith. He'll forgive you for your sin. When all the pleasures of this world fade away, his word will remain. If you would like to know more about Christ and ask for forgiveness of your sins, we have brothers and sisters who would love to pray for you. I would love to pray for you. What an opportunity it is to sing praises to God this morning. We could say Jesus in here. We could sing praises to the most holy God, the light of the world, the Savior of the world. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We pray that you're glorified today. We pray that you're pleased with our worship. We pray that others that don't know you may know you so that they can have the joy of your salvation and no longer walk in darkness. Lord Jesus, shine into our darkness. Drive our dark away so we could see your glory and live for you and be salt and light in this world. Amen. Pray that you guys all have a blessed Sunday, and we have brothers and sisters again who would love to pray for you out here. Have a happy Sunday and a happy New Year. Amen.
of Mr. Kanye West and the entire Sunday Service Collective. I'm hoping that I do.